So I was recently doing an online demonstration of the new transitions in Lumafusion, and a question got raised. What's the difference between push transition and a slide transition if you're using extra layers of video? For example, watch this clip coming up. Looks good. And then we repeat. And it also looks good. Well, the problem is, if I actually zoom in, you'll see the first one is the push down transition. And the second one is push right, whereas in the second grouping of video clips, it's slide down and then slide right. So that begs the question, what is the difference between push and slide transitions? I'm also going to show you how to create this chop, crop, and push technique. Let's get started then. Okay, so when it comes to slides and pushes in terms of transitions, if you're working with them above the timeline, then they're both identical. They work exactly the same as each other. So as you can see in this first clip, I'm pushing down and then I'm pushing in from the left hand side, and again I'm just reversing the action from there, and the slide is exactly the same. If we take a look at it from a timeline point of view, which is the main edit point, if I make a cut here and then we put in slide right, you'll notice the difference. So what happens in sliding right is that it slides over the video clip, and that's the difference between pushing and sliding. Whereas if I close that down and we go to push right, extend it out a little bit, you'll see this time it pushes the video clip out of the way. That's the two main differences between slide and push right, which you don't see if you've got separate layers above. If you want the transition to work as is, you've really got to use it on the main timeline. Now that you know the basics of the push and the slide transition, let's take a look at creating it as its own transition. So I've got a shot of the bedroom, then got a shot of the kitchen, which then goes into another kitchen shot. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this first kitchen shot, move it on to its own timeline above the main timeline, and then what we're going to do is we're going to then duplicate it. So you can either highlight the clip and do Command D on the keyboard, or you can duplicate it via the duplicate button on the timeline. Both are absolutely fine. Now we're going to work with the top clip first of all, and what we're going to do is go into our frame and fit, and we're going to go down to cropping. Now what you want to be able to do is you want to either go left or right. I think I'll go left, it's consistent, and bring the slider in to 50% and get it just nearly spot on. There we go. That then halves that clip up. If we just switch off the visibility of the clip below, you'll then see that clip is at 50% from the left. We're then going to repeat the action for this clip below. Again, back into frame and fit, back into cropping. This time we're going to work from the right and come in to 50%. There we go. And what we've now got is the two halves of the clip. Just switch them both on. You'll see if you've done this correctly, both clips should interact with each other. No hassle at all. Now the clip below, we're going to reduce the amount of information so that the above clip comes in first, then the second clip comes in below. And just to give it a bit of movement, this is where you can use either slides or pushes. Again, at this point, they work exactly the same as each other. I'm just going to use the slide. So in this case, I'm going to slide in from the right, set to roughly about half a second. You'll see that one's coming in there. It slides across. And then I'm going to go and slide down. You'll see when I interact with them, you get chop, crop, and push effect. Now you can have it so by sliding down on the way out, it will just reverse itself in the same way that sliding right will just go backwards exactly the same way. So let's watch the whole thing. Slide across, slide down, and then you can have them sliding across each other on the way back out. Or if you want to, you could do something completely different. It's up to you. It just comes down to creativity, how you actually get the clips interacting with each other. For example, I can switch the slide down to slide up. You get that sort of effect. And what it's doing, obviously, is revealing the new clip below. So you're using a couple of different transitions and two different clips to effectively create your own custom chop, crop, and push transition. Chop, crop, and slide, in this case. And it's a simple and creative way of working a clip to reveal another clip. And that's it for today. So if you've enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. Give the video a like, and I will catch you on the next one. See you later.